यस, वेलकम बैक गाइस. गुंजन, हेलो. प्लीज टेल मी, एम आई ऑडिबल और नॉट? प्लीज टेल मी, एम आई ऑडिबल और नॉट? वेलकम बैक गाइस. ओके, मुथु सैमी, गुड इवनिंग डियर. अभी वाजपेयी, गुड इवनिंग. सो डियर, दिस सेशन इज बेसिकली रिलेटेड टू द न्यूली एडेड टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन इन गेट, दैट इज MSQ स्पेशल, यू नो, मल्टीपल सिलेक्ट क्वेश्चंस. यस, गुड इवनिंग अश्विन, हितेश. ओके, नाइस. सो डियर, व्हेन आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट MSQ स्पेशल, यू मस्ट बी नोइंग दैट देर इज अ स्लाइट चेंज इन द पैटर्न ऑफ गेट. ओके जोन्स, ओके नाइस डियर. घन प्रकाश, गुड इवनिंग. अभय, गुड इवनिंग. ओके नाइस. सो एज आई वाज सेइंग दैट इन द गेट 2021 देर आर सम चेंजेस हैव बीन मेड. यू मस्ट बी अवेयर ऑफ दैट. फर्स्ट चेंजेस, यू नो दैट देर इज सम चेंज इन सिलेबस. इन इंजीनियरिंग मैकेनिक्स सम टॉपिक्स हैव बीन एडिड, बट व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट इंजीनियरिंग मैकेनिक्स, वट एवर द टॉपिक्स हैव बीन एडिड, देवर बेसिकली द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ फ्रिक्शन. सो देवर ऑब्वियसली नॉट मैंशनड इन द कोर्स बिफोर, बट स्टिल मैनी ऑफ अस वर टेकिंग दीज टॉपिक्स इन द क्लासेस. ऑल्सो इन स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ मटीरियल, यू नो दैट शीयर सेंटर हैव बीन एडिड, वी हैव कवर्ड इन द क्लासेज बिफोर ऑल्सो. सो दैट इज नॉट मोर स्पेशल. येस, वन टू थ्री टॉपिक्स आर एडिड इन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग एंड इंडस्ट्रियल ऑल्सो, दैट यू आर डेफिनेटली अवेयर ऑफ. But this session is related to that MSQ of production. That you know, previously there were 70 marks of technical and 30 marks, 15 maths, 15 FT. Now you know there are 30 marks for mathematics and 15 marks for aptitude plus verbal ability. And after then, 72 marks is for technical. Definitely, Gunjan, we will go for theory of machines MSQ also. But firstly, this session is related to production, because the weightage of production is more. So dear, now whenever I am talking about MSQ, these are the newly added topic, newly added way of asking the question. And MSQ type of question, when we are talking about, they will be having multiple select question, and in that more than one options will be correct. If you are going to tick all the correct options, then you are going to get full marks. Otherwise, you will be getting zero. Negative marking will not be there. Okay, so that is the good point. So dear, which kind of question can be asked in production? First of all, I am showing you some of the question. Then I will be having some of the general discussion also related to the changes made in the gate. Like you know, now you can appear for two gate papers at the same time. But yes, they have put it restriction that if you are going for mechanical engineering, then you can go for any XC paper. XC papers are not going to helpful for PSUs. They are going to help you only for M.Tech. Okay, so that you definitely know, I know. So dear, because already at Grade Up YouTube channel only related to that, we have already made one session. So from that also you can see, and you can see whatever the changes they have made. But I will be discussing after discussing some of the questions. So dear, as you know, when you are going for online paper, there are options that which one you can tick it. But there in multiple select question, you can tick more than one options. And if let us say this is the question, this is the question I have made from material science. And definitely, if you will like this session and share with your friends, and if you will request for that, we can have such more session in the upcoming weeks. Because as this is a new pattern, so questions will definitely be new. So more the classes will be engaged for such kind of things, better will be the knowledge you will be getting. For example, let us say this is a question. Grain size refinement can be done by. So there are four options: adding BCC element into FCC elements, by providing higher cooling rates, by providing alloying elements, by providing slow cooling rates. Or if you want to answer, you can answer it. So Ganaprakash have answered A, B, C. So dear, let us say when we are talking about grain size refinement, when I was teaching you material science, I taught you that BCC elements are given a special name. That special name is basically to, okay, Nukla, hello. So the special name given to the BCC elements is basically grain size refiners. So if BCC elements are grain size refiners, it is sure they are going to refine the size if we are adding them in the FCC element. Second, also I have already shown in the class that whenever you are going to provide higher cooling rates, then also with higher cooling rates, more number of grains are there, so grain size will be smaller. Yes, Hitesh, A and B is definitely correct. Nukla, hello, okay. Hemalata, AB is correct. Good, Samarth, AD, no, D is not correct. So dear, we get grain size refinement means small size of grains. Grain size will be smaller if number of grains are more, and number of grains will be more if cooling rates is more. So dear, here A and B are correct. So if, as Ganaprakash have answered it, A, B and C, Ganaprakash will get 0 in this question. But dear, those who have answered it A and B, you will get full marks. The question may be for 1 mark, may be for 2 marks. These questions looks very simple. But my dear, they are just like, if you have seen that assertion reasoning question in ESC, this seems to be simple. But guys, it is very difficult to get marks into that. Because in these questions, if you are not aware of even one thing about that topic, you will be getting 0 for sure. But the good thing is there is no negative marking, so you must attempt for sure. So dear, here the answer will be A and B. And nice, dear, I will be showing that in production how the questions can be asked. You can share this session with your friends because it is a new pattern. You will be learning something new. Okay, guys. So let us see we will be discussing 8 to 10 questions of this type today. And if you will feel that they are going to be helpful for you, we may provide you such sessions in the next coming weekends on your request. Okay, you can request it in the comment box. Then we can go for other subjects and other sessions for production also. So dear, next is this. Cutting fluids. Cutting fluids are those which helps in cutting by providing low shear strength sulfide layers. Cutting fluids are those which helps in taking heat away from the machining area. Cutting fluids are those which helps in the chip disposal. Cutting fluids are those which increase the strength of workpiece. So there are 4 options. These are, as it is a multiple select question, you must be aware about cutting fluid. If you are aware about it, then only you can answer it. Okay. But out of 4, from just looking at the name, you might be knowing 1 to 2 factors. But dear, you must be knowing about all the factors. Then only you can answer such kind of question. So I am expecting the answer. Hitesh is saying B and C. Okay. And Hemalata is saying A, B and C. Okay. Hemalata, you are definitely correct. Now, as I said, generally students do not know the meaning of cutting fluids. Ganaprakash, you are again wrong. This is not good thing. Muthusami, ABC is correct. Abhay Pandey, ABC correct. Samarth Patel, ABC correct. Very nice. So dear, as when I was teaching you metal cutting part, then I told you about cutting fluids. Dear, cutting fluids is the name given. They are generally, students have a misconception that when we are talking about cutting fluid, they feel that cutting fluid and coolant, they are same. So dear, it is not like that. Cutting fluids and coolants, when we are talking about, cutting fluids are somewhere better or extra than the coolants. And when I was teaching you, yes, Kranti Kumar, ABC is correct. When I was teaching, I was telling you that why the name is cutting fluid, because in cutting fluids, we added extreme pressure additives. And these extreme pressure additives includes chlorine, sulfur, phosphorus. And when they have these kind of element, and when this cutting fluid is coming in contact with the workpiece, then manganese is always present as an impurity in the steel. So manganese come out because it gets attracted by sulfur, and it reacted with sulfur to make manganese sulfide layer. And this manganese sulfide layer have very low shear strength. And because of its low shear strength, my dear, it is very easy to remove this layer for cutting tool. But if manganese is present in steel, you know that manganese increase the hardness. If 12% or more than this percentage manganese is present in the steel, that material is used for road roller. And that material is known as head-filled steel. So dear, road roller type of material is made by addition of manganese. So we definitely want to remove this manganese from the steel. And the best way is to provide extreme pressure additives. Extreme pressure additives will be reacting with manganese. So dear, cutting fluid have its first function as it helps in cutting. Okay, reducing the power required, force required. So first is this is correct. Second, my dear, definitely as it is acting like a coolant, so it will take away the heat also. Harshita is saying A and B. Dear, A and B are correct, but C is also correct. Because it is acting and helping as a coolant also. So coolant helps in chip disposal. So A, B, C all will be correct. Okay, D is not correct because it is not going to increase the strength of workpiece. So you will be ticking A, B and C here. So this is MSQ. Okay, dear. So yes, good Abhay Pandey. I am happy that you remember the things I taught to you in the class. Otherwise, Ganaprakash have forgot all those things. Anna Ganaprakash? Okay, no issues, dear. So, this was revision are required basically. The problem is you are not revising. Okay, dear. So, let's see some other questions. Okay. And dear, please share this session with your friends so that they can also be benefited. And please like this session. Next is thermit welding. When we are talking about thermit welding, that is a type of welding. So, there are 4 points related to that. Exothermic chemical reaction type of welding. Used for joining railway tracks. Endothermic chemical reaction type of welding. Radiant energy type of welding. Yes, Ganaprakash, that's what I want to say. So, which of the following are correct? I want to know from your side. Which of the following are correct? What do you feel? I want your opinion because... Okay, this time I feel Ganaprakash have given right answer. Okay, Kishore has also joined. Nice, Kishore, the answer is correct. Hemalata, the answer is correct. Muthuswami, the answer is correct. Bharat, the answer is correct. Bharat, I was missing you. Abhi, the answer is correct. Farooq, good, nice. Gaurav Vajpayee, correct. Gunjan, correct. Abhay, correct. Nice. Arnab, correct. Tarak, correct. Hemalata, okay, already I have given the answer. Harshita is also correct. This time all of you are correct. Nice. Okay, dear. Definitely A and B are correct. Jones, Victor, Mahesh Mishra. Good. So, dear, it is an exothermic type of chemical reaction. The chemical reaction occurs between Fe3O4 plus aluminium. Then it converted into Al2O3 plus iron. So, dear, these are 3 in number and this is 4 in number. So, you will be getting this to be 9 in number. And this is with a lot of energy. And that energy is going to be used in welding. So, it is an exothermic chemical reaction type of welding. That is correct. It is used for joining the railway tracks on site. Basically, it is used in developing countries. Developed countries using some other methods. Okay, no issue, dear. I got your point. Okay, guys. So, this is basically related to thermit welding. Okay, so for this question, all of you have given the right answer. I am happy with that. Let us see what about the next type of question. That is permeability of molding sand. So, this time I have taken only the theoretical question. If we meet for next question, I will be showing MSQ type of numerical how can be made. You might not be remember, but I have discussed one question in strength of material. Which was of same type only. That question was from engineering services. And there the question was related to Mohr circle. And I have given the 4 options. Out of 4, 3 were correct. So I told you at that time that these kind of questions may be coming in the future. Okay. But we have done in that way that we were having the option like which one is correct. 1 and 2 are correct. 2 or 3 and correct. 1, 2, 3 are correct. So they are same only. But without those options. Okay. So... Abhay is saying A, B, C, D. Permeability of molding sand. This should be percentage. Found to be maximum at 8% of the moisture content is a function of moisture content. Can be increased by providing the vent holes. Can be improved by addition of some additives. So, Abhay is saying A, B, C, D. Muthuswami is saying A, B, C. Kishore is saying A, B, C, D. Bharat is saying D, B, A. Okay. So, dear, Abhay is correct. Because, yes, Ganaprakash is saying AB, but here Abhay is correct. Because when I was teaching you in the class, I told you it is found to be maximum in 8%. I have given you the reason behind that too. And second is definitely it is a function of moisture content. We have made a curve also that it was increasing first and decreasing then. It can be increased by providing vent hole in the colleges to improve the permeability of the molding sand. You were having some vent pin was there like this. And by that vent pin, you were making the holes into the molding sand, if you remember. Then there are some additives. By adding them, you can also increase the permeability. Those additives also I have given in the class at that time to you. So dear, that shows who have revised the things properly. So about this question, my dear, now you can see this was the easiest one, but only one student and second student is Ashwin, only and Arnab. Three students have given the answer correctly. Okay, Gunjan also have given. So 3 to 4 students have given the answer correctly. You can see that this kind of questions, when they will be coming, what will be the effect of that? Definitely, it will be reducing the highest mark, which was going more than 19 mechanical. Yes, dear. Bharat, all options may be correct. Then you need to tick like this. There will be an option of ticking. You will be ticking all of them. For example, in MCQ, you tick only one of them. When you will be selecting B, B will be selected. When you will be selecting C, B will be removed. But in this case, you will be selecting MSQ. You can select all the options. That will be the thing given to you in the question. So dear, next question is this. Now let us see how many of you are giving correct answer for this. Atomic hydrogen welding uses electrodes to produce arc. Hydrogen gas is used and also acts as shield gas. It is a type of arc welding or it is a type of gas welding. So dear, let us say how many of you give the correct answer for this. And these are theoretical questions I am discussing today. Next session will be numerical one. Numerical also MSQ can be made. I don't know how many of those gate will be making numerical or theory, but I want to prepare you for all. Ramesh Mohan, good evening, dear. Dear, definitely that thing should be mentioned, Arnab. Abhay, MSQ may be theoretical, may be numerical. So in the next session, I will be showing numerical MSQ also. Now I am discussing theoretical MSQs only. Ganaprakash is saying ABC. Abhay is saying BCA. BD, Ashwin is saying. BND, Hitesh is saying. Kishore is saying BND. Arnab is saying ABC. Tarak is saying ABC. Hemalata is ABD. Viraj is saying BD. Bharat is saying ABC. Sorry dear, nobody of you is correct. Nobody from your side is correct. Hello Vignesh. Muthu Sami is saying BND. Jones Victor is saying BND. Harshita is saying ABC. So dear, definitely it is correct. Uses electrodes to produce the arc. It is also correct. Hydrogen is used and it also acts as shielded gas. But dear, neither it is a type of arc welding nor it is a type of gas welding. It was a combination of these two, and that also not proper composition. It was not the proper arc welding, neither it was proper gas welding. Why? Because neither we were using the heat of arc for welding, nor we were going for chemical reaction for welding. So dear, it was neither a arc welding nor a gas welding. It was a rough combination, and combination was also such that we cannot say it is a combination properly, because it was neither following the principle of arc welding nor the gas welding. So only A and B are correct here. Only A and B are correct. A and B. Okay. So such kind of questions may make you confused. As I already said that these are the types similar to assertion reason. Whenever we solve assertion reason, we feel that yes, I am correct. But dear, very less students answer them correctly. So they are the similar kind gate I have introduced, and I am really happy for that they have done something new. Definitely will result in, obviously Bharat, you need to improve the concept. And you can see my lectures, I have taught each and everything to you in them in a manner that you will be answered to these questions if you are revising. Okay, Kritika Agarwal, so sticky. Abhay, khel gaya. Yes. Ashwin, okay, nice. Okay, thanks Hemalata. Yes, Muthu Sami. Harshita, okay, Harshit Shukla is saying, please explain. Okay, dear, I am explaining it. Basically, atomic hydrogen welding, when we are talking about, the setup is like this. Hydrogen gas will be supplied. and then you will be having tungsten electrode there. And these electrodes, one will be obviously, you know that, cathode, another will be obviously, you know that, anode will be there. And here from this cathode and anode, you know that arc will be generated. There will be a filler rod you will be using. This is filler rod. And this is your workpiece. So what happened is, hydrogen gas will be coming. Arc will be generated. And because of this arc, hydrogen will get break into ions. H plus and H minus ions. Then dear, H plus and H minus ions, how they are formed? Because there is a basic principle of chemistry that if you are going to provide some energy, the bonds will be broken. And if the bonds are going to be made, we will be getting energy. So breaking of hydrogen will result into we need to provide energy. That energy of arc is used in this thing. Then whenever they are meeting, they will be provide you an equivalent amount of energy. Obviously, that you will be getting. Okay. So this energy will be used in welding. This energy will be used in welding. So dear, this is just breaking of hydrogen and just making of hydrogen. These two things are going on. So with that, we are going for atomic hydrogen welding. And you know what was the advantage of that? Because I told you, when we make a curve of conductivity with the air, hydrogen and helium, you know, conductivity increases. This is for air, this is for hydrogen, this is for helium. So if you use air, the conductivity is this one. If you use hydrogen, the conductivity will be this one. So with better conductivity, hydrogen will be capable of supplying more heat to the workpiece. Because of that, efficiency of welding will increase. So this was the target of doing atomic hydrogen welding. I feel the question was asked by Harshit Shukla. Are you getting it? Or if you have any doubt, please ask Harshit. Okay, you already said thanks, sir. Good. So next question is, also in this question I said somebody may be saying you that energy is going to be more in this reaction, less in this reaction. Then I always say those persons, then it is better to just break hydrogen and join them by sitting at home. Produce energy. Don't you feel if here we are providing less energy, here we are getting more energy, it is going to be the challenge for the conservation of energy. Don't you feel that, guys? I feel yes, it will be. Hope you are getting it. Okay. So, nice, dear. Yes, Krishna Rawal. At 7 p.m. we are going to have arc welding session. Any of you, if want to join, just follow me at GradeUp app. Because now on GradeUp app, I will be available regularly. And I will be taking 1 hour session daily related to my all the subjects. And I will be taking some basic theory parts and some very good questions. So you are going to be benefited from that, guys. And if you are going to attend that, it will be helping you in the exams. Okay. So Ganaprakash sir, in rank up and gear. Dear, rank up batch is for practice. Gear up batch is for third year students. For third year student who just want to give the gate this year. So they will be taught according to the GATE syllabus only. And but if you are going to attend both gear up plus rank up, that will give you complete preparation. Rank up will be having 70% numerical, 30% theory. Gear up will be having 70% theory, 30% numerical. Just join them, you will get the complete package. Okay, Kishore is saying ABCD. So all of you guys, you can just follow me on GradeUp app if you want regularly a good lecture for you guys. Kishore is saying ABCD, Ganaprakash ABCD, Hemalata ABCD, Muthusami ABCD, Rohan AC, Krishna Gupta ABC, Bharat BCDA, Abhay Pandey saying ABCD for sure. Yes, Abhi Bajpai, it will be 7 p.m. daily. Ganaprakash is saying okay. Rohan AC, Tarak ABC, Ashwin AND, Tarak ABD, Kritika ABCD, all are correct. Okay, let me tell you now. Flash butt welding, yes, definitely it is a type of resistance welding. As the name is butt welding, it is used for butt joint, it is also correct. These two are correct only. Even this was the reason for which flash butt welding came into picture. It uses a very high current of magnitude 10 power 5 ampere, this point is also correct. And it is used for joining railway tracks in developed countries. In developed countries, not everywhere. So all four are correct here. Yes, it is very nice. Harshit Shukla, D is also correct. Okay. So you can see only a small mistake can make you 0 from 2. You can get 1 to 2 marks or you can get 0 marks depending on your hard work or your knowledge about that topic. That's why I always say follow my notes completely. If you are following my notes completely, every point I have taught, and not only my dear production, whatever the subject you say, I can make this kind of things in front of you that you will not be knowing all the points. Next is this question. Sheet metal cutting operation. So those who have attended the classes properly, they are answering it correctly. Revision is required. So guys, as I am saying, Bharat, okay, before this question, I would like to tell you that Bharat, now under subscription model, whatever the courses will be launched now onwards, if you are going to get subscription or if you are already previous student of grade up, you will be getting all the courses access for free. There is no need to pay anything. Whatever now Master Theory of Machines classes are going to be started, it will be free for all of you students who are already grade up students. And all those students who will be joining now, whatever the courses will be launched afterward, you can join, you can enroll any of the courses. Okay. Yes, Ramesh Mohan, it is dangerous, but it is dangerous if you are not properly following the things. Just follow my notes. I teach each and everything in the class. You will never be getting problem in any of the questions. This is my promise to you. But follow it blindly. Blindly, I am saying, just after having faith only. Okay. First of all, check, attend, and then have faith. And then just follow that. Then don't have any kind of hesitation or problems. Kishore AB, Ganaprakash ABD, Hemalata AB, Rohan BD, Krishna Gupta AC, Kritika ACD, Muthusami AB, Bharat BA, Abhay Pandey AB, not sure about D. Okay, so you cannot write this thing Abhay in the paper. Tarak AB, Harshit Shukla AB, Viraj Shah ABD, Yash Shah D, Abhay Pandey, okay, AB only. Ganaprakash, scrap can be considered as product. The option is out. Okay, dear. So punching and blanking, both are using the same setup, that is sure. One punch is there, die is there. Stress induced is more than ultimate shear strength, that is also correct, because the operation is basically cutting operation. So both A and B are correct for sure. Stress induced are more than yield, less than ultimate. Obviously, this is not correct. In both the processes, we get the same product. It is wrong, because the difference between blanking and punching is related to the product only. In blanking, we get different. In punching, we get different. Dear, everything is possible, Rutvik. Definitely, for making you basically, you can say, confused, they can give such kind of question in a way that only one option may be correct. MSQ means multiple options may be correct. Maybe, must be is not the word. Okay, guys. So many of you have answered it correctly, like Hitesh, Abhi, Ramesh Mohan, and Muthusami, Abhay also, nice. So next question, dear, related to extrusion and wire drawing. Okay, don't worry, the questions are about to end. And guys, dear, clearance makes difference between blanking and punching. It is wrong. Clearance making the difference between blanking, punching, and deep drawing. So Bharat, you are missing deep drawing. That was related to deep drawing. Okay. So dear, please answer this question. Okay, many questions are coming. So basically, first of all, Bharat, it is not die blank clearance. The difference, that clearance difference is between deep drawing and blanking punching. Okay, it is between deep drawing and blanking punching. It is not between blanking and punching. Abhay Singh, okay. Abhi Vajpayee, sir, every MSQ will be of 2 marks or it depends. Dear, it depends on difficulty level. It may be for 1 mark, it may be for 2 marks. If it will be for 2 marks, it is my opinion that they will be asking numerical type of question also. In MSQ, numericals are also possible. Like I give you some data, I ask you multiple things. For example, in Mohr circle, I ask you maximum shear stress, I ask you principal stress, and 4 things I ask out of 4, maybe 2 or 3 are correct. Such questions I will be coming with in the next session if you want that. Tarak is saying ABCD, Hemalata ABC, Krishna Gupta ABC, Kishore ABC, Ganaprakash ABCD. Yash, sir, please. Okay, Yash, your comment, even I cannot, what I say, okay, leave it. So, dear Kritika is AC, thanks for your concern, Yash. Viraj ABCD, Rutvik ABC, Muthusami ABC, Krishna Rawal ABC, Ramesh Mohan ABC, Bharat ABCD. ABC but holds for sometimes, so not D. Harshit ABD, Abhi Vajpayee ABCD, Janish AB. So dear, extrusion and wire drawing operation, both are bulk metal forming operation, that you know. Stress induces more than SYT, less than SUT, that you know. In extrusion, stresses are 3D compressive, but in wire drawing, they are tensile, that is also correct. In both, elastic recovery exists, this is not correct. Because whenever I was teaching you strength of material, I told you that the phenomena of elastic recovery is there only in tension. It is not there in compression, because in compression there is just a mean flow stress. And if you are going to compress it like it up to this, it will be compressed up to this only. Because it is a plastic or permanent flow, in compression at flow stress, you will not be having any kind of elastic recovery. So D is not correct, ABC are correct. Many of you have given answer correctly. Bharat, you have given it wrong. Harshit also wrong. Abhi also wrong. So many of you are wrong. Okay. No, Kritika, there is no negative marking for MSQ. There is no negative marking for MSQ. Okay, dear. So hope you are getting. So guys, enjoying the session or not? Please tell me. If you want, we can go for such more sessions also. And please like this session and share this session. Muthusami, sir, target batch students really missing your SOM classes. Thanks, Muthusami, for your wonderful concern. Definitely, we may meet for some other subject, but don't worry. Okay, Tarak is saying, sir, D thoda samjhao na. Dear, there is a phenomena known as elastic recovery. When we are talking about elastic recovery, you know that when we make some stress strain diagram. So, in stress strain diagram, let us say you are going to load the material up to this point. So, you know that during loading, this part is said to be elastic and this part is said to be plastic. So, for the complete deformation, some part is elastic, some part is plastic. Okay. So, elastic has a definition that it is not there when the loads are removed. Elasticity is the property by virtue of which a material regain its shape and size after removal of load. So you are going to load the material up to this point and then you are going to unload it. When you will be unloading it, this is elastic deformation, which will no longer be there with material after removal. So material will not get this much size up to which you are giving the load. Neither material will come to its original point because there is some plastic part also. So when you are going to unload it, material will be following a line parallel to this line. Means if this slope is theta, this slope will also be theta. So final size the material will be having will be this one. So this is the plastic which is remained with material. This is the elastic which is regained by the material after unloading. But dear, this thing is there only for tension. For compression, it is not there. For compression, if you are loading up to this, your size and shape will be up to this only. And that's why in wire drawing, you provide some, like when you make the dies, you make it and you provide some relief there. Relief is there for this elastic recovery also. Okay, this is relief section, na? in the wire drawing. Who have asked this question? I don't know. I feel the question was asked from. Okay, I don't know, but who have asked, I feel, are you getting it or not? Thanks guys for your wonderful words. Definitely, Kritika, we will be planning more such sessions. If you want that, definitely you must comment in the comment section, because your comments will go to the Grade Up team and they will definitely go for that. Okay, and please like and share this session so that maximum students gets advantage of that. Could you please arrange class for stress tinker for different engineering materials? Muthusami, I feel if you are Grade Up student, then definitely there will be a special course will be available soon for strength of materials also, like theory of machines we are doing. So it will be better that you join Gear Up batch or some other batch there we will be going for. And also if you join me on Grade Up app, I will be taking a session related to that very soon. It will be very good for you if you follow me on Grade Up app, because I am going to take such kind of topics where students have problems with very good questions. Okay. Jones Victor, basically special playlist for production is soon going to be coming on YouTube, and that will be coming I feel after 1 week or 2 weeks. I am going to plan for it. So just wait for that. But still there are some lectures of mine are available. Yes, Ganaprakash, that will be correct. Okay, dear. Thanks, Hemalata. Thanks, Krishna Rawal. Okay, Dikshant, good evening. Okay, guys, I feel now we shall move further. Okay, this question. Let us see now. Yes, Krishna, still we will be soon planning such session also. So dear, this is a question from crystal defects. So this session is related to production. Soon we will be having related to theory of machines also. Hemalata, thanks again, dear, for your wonderful words. When we talk about crystal defects, they refers to short range deviation. They refers to long range deviation should be the word. Okay, they comes because of thermal excitation and addition of alloying element. They can be eliminated by increasing temperature or pressure. Bharat is saying AC, Kishore is saying AC, Abhay is saying ABC. Dear Abhay, sorry to say you are wrong. Hemalata is saying AC. Yes, no doubt about that. A and C are correct. B is not correct, because how can be the same thing will be having short and long range both? Either it will be short range or it will be long range. Long range deviation resulted in amorphous structure. So amorphous structure cannot have crystal defect. Only crystalline structure can have crystal defects. Okay, Abhay and all of you. So the answer is A and C. Harshit Shukla, many of you have given ABC. So long range deviation results in amorphous structure. If it is crystalline, we cannot say this. Kritika Agarwal, ACD, Virat Singh, AC. So A and C are correct, dear. Any doubt, please ask me. Okay, this is the last question for this class. And before coming on to this, I will be giving a small introduction related to the Grade Up Super, because they have just started it. So just an introduction that this is a Grade Up Super is started, and you can please download the app. And if you're going to go for Grade Up Super, now we are having a subscription model under which if you are going to subscribe, you will be accessing more than 8 courses are available in mechanical engineering, and all other branches, many courses are available. So under subscription model, you can go for multiple batches. There will be subject wise batches. There will be some different batches which are related to previous year's GATE, previous year's engineering services question solution. And there are batches related to rank up, that is a practice session batch. There will be a gear up for third year student. So 8 plus batches are there, and you can enroll all of them just by having a subscription. And if you are going to Do it right now. You will be having 2 times validity and this 20% discount. This is just from GradeUp side. I am just announcing it. You can download and you can see if it is of your use. Thanks, Dikshant. Okay, Kritika, I am coming to D option. Okay, Abhay, you want to make all the mistakes right now. So this is related to Mega Mock Challenge. You can go appear for the paper test. And this is Rank Up course, which is going to be there. Here 30% theory plus 70% numericals will be taught to you. Numericals will be other than GATE. So it will be a practice session batch, you can say. Or you can say it is a CTQ batch, concept through question. Going to be helpful for those whose syllabuses are over up to August or September. Okay, these are the features of this course. So I feel this much was for announcing. Now let us. For Vision 2 is possible to listen the class of, yes dear Bharat, now you can enroll for that. Now you can enroll for that. Vision 3, please enroll within this week only, because only 1 week time is there to enroll Vision 3 batch. You can even go for AMESC batch. You can join paper 1 there. Okay, one student I've asked, sir, please explain about D. They can be eliminated by increasing temperature and pressure. Dear, if you will be increasing temperature and pressure, crystal defect cannot be eliminated, but they will be increased in number. Because if temperature increases, thermal excitation will be there. By taking more heat because of temperature, they will just be leaving their places and more vacancies will be there. More and more Schottky defect will be there. So defect will only be increased. So D option is wrong. So dear, if it is not showing for you, please talk to management related to that. This is the last question for today's class. After that, I will say goodbye to you. And you can join me at 7 p.m. on GradeUp app for the very basic part of production, arc welding. Soon I will be planning to start a question series for multiple subjects where I will be discussing very nice questions. So please follow me on GradeUp app if you want to attend such kind of series. That will be for surely free. Farooq, at 7 p.m. it will be. But yes, you are having classes of thermodynamics. You can attend the recorded session of that. Don't worry. Kishore is saying A, B, C, D. Please answer it, dear. Last question it is. After that, I will say you goodbye. Last question. A, B, C, Ganaprakash, Bharat, A, B, C, D. All others, guys. Tarak, A, B, C, D. Okay, A is used for making components like cutting tools, small gears and cams. It should be cams. So dear, yes, it is correct. No doubt about that. Used for making a product of two elements with large difference in melting point. Yes, powder metallurgy have that advantage that you can even join tungsten with copper. 3000 degrees Celsius difference is there between temperature. Used for self-lubricating bearing. Bilkul, that is also correct. Used for making components with very high density. It is not correct here. Because powder metallurgy have only one disadvantage that low density components are made. Low density components are made. This is the disadvantage, major disadvantage. Okay, guys. So this was MSQ session. So guys, please, before leaving, like and share this session to your friends so that they can be benefited. And if you really want such kind of sessions to be there more and more in number for you guys, please give some comments in the comment section. And goodbye for this session, guys. We will be meeting soon for other subjects. And thanks for your love and support. Okay, so let's meet soon. Goodbye.